Do you want a free website to showcase your coding skills and knowledge to the recruiter in a most practical manner? Or do you just want to make an online portfolio, or you want to make a website to flaunt at your friends? Then this video is just for you. In today's video, we are going to talk about some special and hidden features of GitHub, which even most of the GitHub users who use it daily don't know about it. Hi everyone, I am KAUSTUBH SHARMA, AWS Certified Developer and Solution Architect, your multi-cloud DevOps guy. And I post videos on the most advanced technologies used in the real-world IT industry. So if you are watching me for the very first time, then subscribe to my channel so you won't be left behind in the race of ever-growing IT industry.
So we are on the home screen page of our GitHub repository. You can see my GitHub repository is available at this URL, github.com/KAUSTUBH SHARMA professional. So currently I don't have any public repository. So let me tell you about two very special repository which you can make on your GitHub profile. So first just go to repositories, click on new. And so here you can see my owner name is coming as KAUSTUBH SHARMA professional. So what you can name it exactly same as what is your owner's name. So as soon as I finish writing the same name, I get a pop-up that this repository is a very special one, and you can add a readme.md file to your GitHub profile. So this makes this profile very special. So what it will do, it will show at the very front page of my GitHub profile. So let me practically show that how we can do that. Make sure to make this repository as public so anyone on the internet can see that. Just click on this readme.file and just quickly choose the license as well and click on create repository. So you can see I have got a readme.md file and a license file here, and in readme.md file some text is there. Hi there. Let me go to readme.file. So this is our readme file, and here is our edit button. Just click on this. You can see there is a particular performance given, so you can use it. So just it is commented, so let me remove the comment. And you can start writing about yourself. So I am currently working on cloud and DevOps. Currently learning about GitOps, AI and ML. So if you are interested in any of these topics, then you can collaborate me on my YouTube channel, on about topics, on my YouTube channel. Here is the URL. So I have a dedicated URL on YouTube. So you have to just put youtube.com/KAUSTUBH SHARMA and you will automatically reach to my channel. And also I'm looking for help with about topics, same. Also, if you need any help from me, then comment at comment on any video. You can ask me about anything related to cloud, anything related to AWS, Azure, GCP. I have worked on all the three major cloud service providers, Kubernetes, Terraform, Jenkins, and other DevOps tools. And as I already told, you can reach me by commenting on this channel. Let me add my LinkedIn profile as well. So LinkedIn, I'm available on with linkedin.com/in/KAUSTUBH/SHARMA-official. Can pronounce me as he, him. Fun fact would be, now you know me, it's a fact. So now you can commit the changes. And as soon as you make the changes, you can see your readme file is updated. And here is very good looking profile you can see. And now if you go to the main page of your GitHub URL, it will be available here as well. So that's the benefit of making the repository a same name as your owner. Another special repository, let me show you about that. It is a very special one, more special than this. So what you can do, you can just click on new. And just again type the same name as owner, that is KAUSTUBH SHARMA. So for me it is KAUSTUBH SHARMA professional. If you have any other username, then you can make it. And it is saying already exists on this account. Yeah, so we have to make some changes in it. After that you have to write .github.io. so now it is available. And this is another special repository. And also make sure to it be a public one. Add a readme file, add a license, click on create repository. And you can see again I have these two files. So what is so special about this repository, you are asking? This repository will automatically make the website of your own, right? You heard it right, you get a free website automatically. So now if I go to https://yourownersname.github.io to KAUSTUBH SHARMA professional.github.io. Yes, you got a very personal website of your own. So you can see whatever I write there in that readme file, it will be available there. And it is an HTTPS URL, so SSL certificate is also attached. If you know this stuff, then you can type it and publish it to the world on this very own personal domain as well, and your personal website. So this is a very special. If you want to more improve it, just say you see this is looking not good as a developer on your website, that this site is open source. So if you want to remove that, so what you can do, or if you want to add the code to your repository, you want to make your own, you don't want to like a text. So what you can do, you can add a file. And this file should be named as index.html. Okay, HTML, and just put a head tag. Side head, let's make a nice title. What should I make the S title? It is my first website. And now start with the body tag. Make sure to close the tag as soon as you write the starting tag. So this is a very good developer habit. And then write starting, and then start writing inside it. And after that you can type hello world and just add the HTML tag as well. So make the title tag close. Commit the changes. And after committing the changes, go to your website. And it will take around 2 minutes to sync your website with your GitHub repository. So till then you can wait for the 2 minutes, or you can just refresh like your multi-cloud DevOps guy. And you can see the changes are already made. Here is our title, here is our body content. And if you know how to code, then start coding and you can just start your own website for very free. So both of these repositories are special repositories which we are using for making our GitHub profile look better. And another one we are using to get a free domain with the SSL certificate, and we can code as well. And if you don't want to use code, then you can add it in the readme file and it will automatically shown here.
If you still have any doubts or if you are facing any issue in between the process, then please don't think twice to ask me in the comment section. And also, if you have watched the video till here, then please let me know in the comment section by typing "I have watched the full video and it was awesome." Even if you are the only one who comments, I am going to talk to you in comments, and for sure you will get the special like from me on every single comment. I hope you got a clear understanding of how we can create these two special repositories. You can treat these repositories as the folders on your Windows machine. And congratulations to you guys, as we have covered many topics under this example. Now we know that how to create a GitHub repository, how to create a website from GitHub repository with coding and without coding. I hope this will help you in your interview as well by showing your code to the recruiter. And if you get a sense or feeling of gaining any knowledge and skill through this video, and if so, then don't forget to like, subscribe and share this video. This will support and motivate me to publish more content like this.